a bud garden today, and we'll get to that real quick. Miss Linda, do you have any announcements before we start?
Just a little reminder, tomorrow, the reason I'm wearing this butterfly headband is because it's our grand opening of the butterfly garden, and you are all invited to come and Zoom in. The Zoom address is on Facebook. You'll find it right on the Facebook page. And if you have registered to get one of our craft kits, then make sure you pick it up today from 12 to 6. Miss Isella will be glad to bring them out to you at the Warmack Library. The address is imena@gptx.org, and it will be posted on our program today. Okay.
Okay, what do we have today? Like I said, we have a bug garden. Like always, this is a bilingual program, so we'll say it in English and then in Spanish. So, hola a todos, gracias. Con estar con nosotros otra vez. Si no vieron nuestro video con Miss Linda, después de este, vean, chequen ese video. Ella me dio buns. Is this your first video? Be sure to watch Miss Linda's story after this video. But let me tell you guys the materials we have today. We have really, really simple stuff here that you can find at home. So what we all need is an egg carton. Here, this is a paper one, but I know they have like styrofoam egg cartons. Whatever you have at home works. What else do we have? We have, you'll need some scissors, you'll need some paint if you want, and I'll get to that later. Some crayons or markers, some googly eyes, and pipe cleaners. Like I said before, in every video, we like to mention that you guys can use whatever you have at home. If you don't have pipe cleaners or paint or whatever, use whatever you have at home. Para la actividad de hoy van a necesitar un cartón de huevos. Lo van a recortar. Van a necesitar tijeras. Van a necesitar crayones, pintura, todo lo que sea que tengan en casa. Marcadores, si quieren unos ojos locos, si tienen en casa, y un limpiapipas. Y como siempre les decimos, si no tienen esos materiales en casa, pueden usar lo que ustedes tengan. Y si no quieren usar eso, hagan su manualidad como ustedes gustan. But we can get started here. Miss Linda, what did you make?
Well, I made ladybugs. So here is my ladybug puppet. And here are my two little ladybugs. This one, I just used a Sharpie marker and colored it. Then I just cut out like a little half of an egg shape out of black paper, just glued it on with little pieces of pipe cleaner and some googly eyes. And if I didn't have googly eyes, I would just cut eyes out of construction paper. And this guy looks just a little bit different because I painted him. I had some red paint. Oh, and I forgot, you know, ladybugs have all sorts of little spots, and they're not always red. If you don't have red markers, there are yellow ladybugs, and I'm trying to think, I've seen orange ones. So, but I did the same thing. I just cut out paper, googly eyes, and pipe cleaner, and glued it on. Whenever I use glue, I always hold whatever I'm gluing for about, I count to 50. Because glue takes a while to dry, and then I just leave them alone for a while.
This is Miss Linda aquí. Ella hizo en casa unas mariquitas con todos los materiales. Ella hizo dos versiones. Esta mariquita, ella usó pintura y recortó papel negro para hacer la carita y las manchitas atrás. Y usó limpiapipas para hacer su insecto. Y también si no tienen pintura en casa, pueden usar marcadores. Ella usó marcadores para pintar la mariquita roja y pasar las manchitas también. Entonces,
I forgot to say, I drew the spots on one of them and I used a hole punch and black paper for the other. And I'm going to tell you that I love ladybugs. They're really good for your garden because some of the bugs that eat your vegetables or your flowers, well, they like to eat them. So they're very good for your garden. You can actually buy bags of ladybugs at a garden center and then let them go in your garden.
Do you like spiders?
Okay, I'm gonna say yes, they're very good for your garden also.
Okay. I do not like spiders, but I like making spiders. I think spiders are cool looking, but I'm just very scared of them. So I made two little spiders for you guys to see. And again, we just cut our egg carton like so. And I used some black crayons, just color it all. And I put a ton of eyes on my spider. I don't know if you can see that, but he looks so creepy. He looks cute at the same time. So I colored my egg carton with a black crayon. And I just glued a ton of googly eyes. And I cut some pipe cleaners to make some legs. So this one I used crayons. And for this tiny one here, I used some paints.
And they look a little different.
Yeah. Whatever you have at home, just use whatever you have. A mí no me gustan las arañas, pero yo hice dos aquí. En nuestra primera araña, usé colores, crayones. Usé uno negro y nomás lo pinté negro. Adentro también lo pinté y luego recorté las limpiapipas para hacer... ¿Sí? ¿Ahí se lo ven?
Did you hot glue the legs?
Yes, I did. I did hot glue, but any type of craft glue that you have will work. And también hice uno chiquito aquí. Pueden usar lo que ustedes quieran. And I think we're ready to show an example here of how you can make turn your egg carton into a bug. So you get your scissors and you just cut one if you want to make a spider or ladybug. Or if you want to make one of these two. You can keep it long and not cut it, and you can make a caterpillar if you want.
I love the caterpillar. He is
cute.
So cute.
This one's
kind of like the very hungry caterpillar.
Yeah. Entonces, como les estaba diciendo, para hacer su araña o su mariquita, nomás recorten el cartón de huevos. Pero si quieren hacer una oruga, con lo que yo hice aquí, lo pueden dejar así si gustan. So, Miss Lena, do you want to make a ladybug? Just show them how to color.
And you know, one of the things when you cut the egg carton, there's going to be lots of little bits of paper. We'll just kind of cut around it and try to make it as round as we can. And
can you pass me a black crayon?
Oh, I don't know if I can find the black crayon in all of this box. Let's see here, Missy Sella. You've given me a hard job. How about? Oh.
And also, spiders come in a ton of colors, so if you don't want to use black, that's
yeah,
totally fine.
Yeah, why don't we use. Café.
Oh, thank you. Como le estaba diciendo Miss Linda, las
Actually,
arañas.
This might be a better café. I thought it was red.
Vienen en muchos colores, entonces ustedes pueden pintar su araña o sus insectos como ustedes gustan. So, I'm going to try to color it really fast for you guys because I know you guys can't see it. Sorry, I'm doing this really fast. It might not look very nice.
It's a little bit easier with marker, but I love the way. Those spiders, I was wondering what you did to get that gray. They look kind of gray, they're cool looking. And that was crayon.
Lo voy a hacer muy rápido para que ustedes puedan ver. Sé que está un poquito lejos la cámara. Entonces lo voy a pintar muy rápido. No se va a ver muy bien, pero.
Well,
you can kind of see.
Yeah. So we kind of gave them a color, but I would color a little bit more.
Yeah. Take some time coloring. It's kind of hard to get inside the ridges.
And remember all the bugs that we read about in the story. You could make grasshoppers. You could make a bee. You could make, what else? A roly-poly. Lots of roly-polies in our gardens. I'm trying to think what else was spiders. And you could make a whole collection of bugs. You can get a lot of bugs out of one egg carton. Okie dokes. So, I don't have the construction paper to make his face, but you know what I could do? I could just draw the face.
You could.
I think I will. Find a black crayon, that would be great.
So now I'm going to attach his legs. I just cut the pipe cleaners. Quiero que mi araña
putting little spots on my ladybug with my blue crayon, and I'm gonna glue some eyes. I think I'm gonna give her big eyes this time. You know, you can get a lot of these things at the dollar store.
Yeah.
The dollar store has great craft things, and everything costs a dollar, which is wonderful. That's where I shop.
Me lo estaba diciendo que muchos de los materiales que nosotros usamos los pueden encontrar en el dollar store, en Dollar Tree. Y está muy barato. Entonces ya tiene tres o
thing. If I'm making a ladybug, I think just needs a little bit of antenna. I need a little antennas up here. So you have a little scissors at home?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Easy peasy.
I'm really proud of my caterpillar. Me gusta mucho mi oruga.
Okay, we're just about out of our glue here, so.
Okay, I'm just gonna have my sweater cup too, that's fine.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll attach those antenna and curl them after it kind of dries a little bit. Okay, this one just doesn't have enough glue on it. We just ran out. Anyway, there's our little ladybug, the quick version of it. And anything else we want to say?
In our other video, we mentioned that if you've been enjoying our bilingual programs, we have two bilingual programs a week. Tomorrow we'll have bilingual song and story with Miss Camille. Mañana, si le gustan estos videos bilingües, tenemos dos programas bilingües cada semana aquí en Facebook. Mañana vamos a tener una canción y una historia original con Miss Camille. Entonces, si quieren ver más videos en español, métense en nuestro Facebook mañana a las 11. But I think that's all we have today,
okay.
All of our announcements. Thank you so much for joining us once again. Again, if you have enjoyed being with us, be sure to stick on next week at the same time at 11 here on our Facebook page, and I hope to see you guys soon. Again, if you guys recreate any of our crafts, be sure to comment on this video and maybe add a photo of your craft. But we'll say goodbye, and we'll see you guys next week.
And go out into your garden and look for your bugs and make some.
Bye.
We miss you. Bye, everybody.